Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to Cinema Theatre's 100 Days of Wonders on Digital. We now kindly ask you to turn off all your mobile phones and any other devices that may affect the magical pantomime. Boys and girls of all ages, it's time to boo, hiss, cheer as loud as you possibly can. Welcome to the magic of
Rat is a stinker, and he's not very nice.
Who dares to add a name, King Rat? If I find who it is, I'll squash him flat.
Hang on a minute, the old cock and sparrow. You're the one that's furry and cower.
You're no match for me, you're just a fairy. Am I supposed to find you scary? Don't make me laugh, just go away. It's time for me to win the day. Cause I'm the leader of the pack. I'm evil, I'm cruel, and my heart is black.
Is that the best you can do? You don't frighten us. You'll soon be defeated by a boy and his pups.
Hey, don't mention cats, they make me sick.
Then it's time you met our hero, Dick.
Who is this boy and why should I care?
Because one day soon he'll be London's Lord Mayor.
Oh, and I'll still rule London, he won't change that.
Oh yes he will, with the help of Tomatoes, the cat.
Don't mention cats, I've warned you, stop it. Them furry felines make me vomit. Master Dick and Bell, watch out, for I'll rule this town, be sure of that. I'll ruin him, that's what I'll do, and then I'll be back for all of you, and you. But there's nothing that I fear. Not Whittington nor his mingy cat, cause they'll never match the great King Rat.
Oh, good riddance, you fear. Go back to hell. Oh, hasn't he left a nasty smell? Now, it's time for me to tell my story. Dick Whittington's tale of fame, fortune and glory. For our hero really is no imposter. He's heading to London, straight from Gloucester. Oh, the city of London's the place to be. The most beautiful place. Just wait and see. You might think beauty comes in spring and summer, when the sunrise hits the morning dew. But if you walk the straight and narrow, you'll find that happiness and dreams are there for.
Do you know where the most beautiful place in the world is, my boy?
London.
The most beautiful place in the world. The most beautiful place in the world. Really, that I know. Sing it, son. The most beautiful place in the world. The most beautiful place in the world. Really, it's beautiful. The London streets are paved with gold.
As Dick grew older, he still loved to hear the tales of London and dreamed to be near the most beautiful place he could only imagine, that glittered and marvelled with all its attractions.
you made it. And it's just like Dad said it was.
Meow.
What was that, Tommy? How do I know it's London? Well, let's see. That's Big Ben, and that's St Paul's Cathedral, and that's Buckingham Palace, and look, that's the London Eye. Can't you tell we're in London, Tommy? It's obvious. Nobody's talking to us. Well, I suppose that's because we haven't introduced ourselves. I'm Richard Whittington, but my friends all call me Dick. And this is my trusty cat Tomatoes, Tommy for short. Now come and say hello to the boys and girls, Tommy. Would you like to meet him, boys and girls?
Yes.
See, Tommy? There's no need to be shy. These are our friends. Now, after three, I want you to say, hello, Tommy! Do you think you can do that?
Yeah.
Do you think you can do that?
Yeah.
Okay, let's give it a go. One, two, three. Tommy and I have travelled all the way from Gloucester in search of our fortune. Tommy's my best friend in the whole world. He's such a clever cat, and he loves chasing mice and rats too. See what I mean? Tommy was the best rat catcher in all of Gloucester. I'd better go and find him. We need a job and somewhere to stay. See you later, boys and girls.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Miss Alice.
It's just a lovely day.
I wouldn't say that.
Why not? Whatever's the matter?
Those horrible rats are everywhere. The streets are crawling with them.
I know. I thought we got rid of them.
Something has to be done. They're in every school.
Every kitchen.
There was one even at the end of my bed this morning.
Got to be done before it's too late.
Oh, maybe my father will know what to do.
Here he comes now.
Good morning, Mr. Fitzwarren.
Whatever's the matter, you all look really fed up.
Oh, it's the rats again, Daddy. They're back.
Oh, dear. I thought it was too good to be true.
Is there anything you can do to help?
I wish there was. I would do anything to get rid of those vile creatures once and for all. But we've tried everything. Even that Piper fella couldn't do it. They've even started eating all the sweets in the shop. Soon there'll be nothing left to sell and nothing left for Cook to make. I must think of something before the saucy south sets sail on Saturday. Otherwise, I'll have nothing left in the school to come back to.
Oh, gosh. Wow, what a brave cat you are chasing off those rats.
There's a cat.
I wonder where his owner is.
Yeah, I'll send him over and lost too. Maybe that's right.
Well, he certainly did a good job of chasing off all those rats. I could do with a cat like this in my store, but a brave cat like this, you must surely have a master.
Tommy! Tommy! There you are, Tommy. I thought I'd lost you.
Now?
Alderman Fitzwarren, young man. Is this your cat?
Indeed it is, sir. Richard Whittington at your service. But you can call me Dick.
Pleased to meet you, Dick.
This is my daughter, Alice, and this is our shop, Fitzwarren Stores. I must say, your cat's very impressive. What's his name?
This is Tomatoes, Mr. Fitzwarren. Tommy, for short.
I could do with a cat like Tommy in my store. Chasing away any unwanted rats. How much do you want for him?
I couldn't possibly sell Tommy. He's my best friend. Besides, we've travelled all the way from Gloucester to seek our fortune. You see, one day, I'm going to become the Lord Mayor of London.
Lord Mayor!
Yes, sir. Now, can anyone tell me where I can find the streets paved with gold? What's so funny?
Don't you think the streets are paved with gold since Theresa May got it?
Yes, personally, I blame Brexit.
And to pay for rats, no one wants to come to London since they arrived.
Well, there must be something we can do.
Oh, believe me, we've tried everything. We just can't seem to get rid of them.
Well, maybe I'll...
Really?
Look, I can't sell you Tommy, but I could loan him to you for a while. He'd get rid of these rats in no time. In return, we need a job and somewhere to stay. What do you say, Mr. Fitzwarren?
Oh, please, Daddy, you're always moaning that you need an extra pair of hands in the shop.
Excuse me, young lady, I don't always moan. Although, an extra pair of hands would be useful, especially with my upcoming voyage only a few days away. What do you say, Dick?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You can stay with us. We have a deal, okay?
Yay! Yay. Right, Dick, I'll show you and Tommy the way.
Because I have a scheme to stop young Dick. My plans to rule all London town will turn their smiles into a frown. Oh, yes, they will. Oh, it's going to have to be louder than that. Oh, yes, they will. Oh, yes, they will. Shut your faces, you make me sick. There's no way that cat'll do the trick. For I've a plan to take Dick down. And when I have, I'll rule this town. In every home, on every street, my rats they never will defeat. Cause causing mayhem is my game, and vermin is my middle name. First, I'll ruin London's civilization. Then I'll have world domination. Free me with my cunning ploy. A rancid sidekick I'll employ. Bins and sewers is where he'll lurk, ready to do my dirty work. Now he's got no brains, and he ain't a thinker. But I give to you my slave, the stinker. What took you so long? There's work to be done. I need you to go and spy on someone.
Alright, alright. Keep your fur on. Don't get your tail in a twist.
Shut up and listen, you stupid rat. It's time to teach a lesson to Dick and his cats.
Oh, but I'm frightened of cats. They give me the willies.
What you just do as you're told, you filthy rodent. And help me squash this unworthy opponent. Now there really is no time to pause. Let's make our way to Fitzwarren's stores.
Wakey, wakey!
Rising, Joe!
We're Bartlett Sam!
Always on time!
Give me that!
Oh, why are you crying tickle?
Maybe I should try my whistle!
Oh, she must be the dick slick! There's only one thing for her!
Oh, no! You're not going to sing, are you?
Well, what do you suggest?
In a situation like this, we must use our brains, Sammy.
All the monsters. If I had brains, I'd be dangerous.
Definitely not wrong there. Are you giving me an idea?
I am, but I don't know how.
What would you do if you were in danger?
Oh, I love quizzes, Billy. What do I win if I get it right?
Concentrate, Sammy.
I lie under the bed.
Really?
I can't lie in the wardrobe.
Wardrobe? No. If you're in danger. You sound the alarm!
Ooh, like this one?
Like that one! Go on then!
Go on what?
Praises!
Ooh, I can't do that if I wake her up!
That's the idea!
Ooh, shall I press it, boys and girls? Yeah! Yeah! Five and up and three! One, two, three!
I dreamt I was on a desert island with Zac Efron and Tom Hardy.
Daddy,
who are you?
My name's Billy Bottle, and this is
Sammy Sack.
Bottle Sack, that rings a bell.
We have a delivery for you from Wither and Spoons.
Delivery? Yeah, the Dame Sarah the Cook, owner of Fitzwarren Store. That's you, isn't it?
Dame Sarah, no, she's my auntie. I'm Silly Sally, but my friends call me Silly. I mean Sally.
Nice to meet you, Sally.
Oh, where do you want these?
Hey, put it over here. What's in it?
Well, we only deal with British produce. So we have Chelsea Banks.
Yep, we got baked tarts.
Got rissoles.
And arseholes.
Our toes arseholes are the very best.
Oh, lovely. Dame Sarah will be pleased. Do I best get this lot packed away then?
We best be on our way, Sally. Come along.
Hi, Sammy.
See you next time. Ooh, what a lush, boys and girls. Oh, I think I'm in love. Oh, I haven't told you who I am yet, have I? I'm Silly Sally from Somerset, currently down from Bristol. I grew up on a big farm near East Dock Hill. The old family are farmers, and they wanted me to be a farmer too. But the thing is, boys and girls, I let you into a little secret. I'm scared of pigs and cows.
Oh, the worst of all,
I'm scared of chickens. I can't even look at it without getting the wibbly wobbly woos. I decided to move down here to London. I always fancied working at Madame Tussauds or the London Dungeons, but they had no vacancies. So I moved in here with my auntie Dame Sarah the cook. I help her in the kitchen and do jobs for Mr. Fitzy in the shop. Well, I'm always getting into trouble for something. Most of the time it's falling asleep or being late. You see, this morning I was supposed to take this piece of Stilton cheese over to Mrs. Pickles. I overslept. Poor Dame Sarah finds out I'll be in big trouble. So I'm just gonna hide it over here. If anyone goes near it, you will tell me, won't you?
Yeah!
Oh, are you sure?
Yeah!
Okay then, if they do, I want you to shout, "Silly Sally, save the Stilton." Can you do that for me?
Yeah!
You might need a bit of practice. Okay, so after three, "Silly Sally, save the Stilton." 1, 2, 3!
Silly Sally, save the Stilton!
Great, now I'll pretend to be the cheese thief. After three, 1, 2, 3!
Silly Sally, save the Stilton!
Oh, you can do better than that. After three, this is really important cheese. 1, 2, 3!
Silly Sally, save the Stilton!
Thank you, boys and girls, you're the best!
Sally! Sally, where are you?
Oh, you, that's my aunt. I best look busy.
Oh. Yoo-hoo!
There you are, you silly girl. Did you hear me calling you? I'm sure you must have pot ears.
Hey.
Don't play silly beggars. You heard me. What on earth are you doing anyway?
Nothing!
Sounds about right. You're always doing nothing. You were supposed to help me in the kitchen this morning. What happened?
Well, my alarm didn't go off.
Well, what's the matter with it then? Is it broken?
No, I've got
Is it any wonder they call you Silly Sally? Sometimes I don't know whether you're stupid or bone-idle.
I'm neither.
Well, what are you then?
Just tired.
How could you be so tired all the time? All you ever do is sleep. If you just put half as much effort as you do into sleeping into your exams, you might have passed a few more.
Actually, I passed two.
Oh, really? And what were they then?
Fine art and media studies.
Fine art? It takes all your time to draw breath. What was the other one again?
Media studies.
So media studies? And what does that involve? Well, hang on, let me guess. You have to watch Fletnix and update your Twitter feed.
Me, just read a paper and watch a telly.
We haven't got time for this. We've got cleaning to do. And you need to put that cake in the oven. Gas mark 5 for 45 minutes. And don't fall asleep again. That cake's for Miss Alice's birthday tomorrow.
Well, I'm not that silly, you know. See you later, boys and girls!
Oh, I don't know. These millennials, they haven't got a clue, have they? That girl's so lazy, she's worse than I was at her age. Oh, here's me rabbiting on. I haven't even introduced myself. I'm Dame Sarah the cook, and I work here in Alderman Fitzwarren's stores. I'm the cook, the cleaner, the shop assistant, the nose wiper, and general dog's body. But it's okay, it's nice to be needed, isn't it? Has anyone ever met Alderman Fitzwarren?
Yes.
Have you? Has anyone met Alderman Fitzwarren?
Yes.
I think he fancies me. He... Oh, yes, he does. He might be my husband number 8. My last husband died. I said my last husband died. Oh, no, don't be silly. You don't need to do that. Actually, I was glad to get rid of him. Moan, moan, moan. That's all he ever did. This one year at Christmas, I asked him what he wanted as a present. He said a divorce. I said I'm not spending that much. So we compromised and I got him a rescue dog. It gets worse. I think the dog's last owner must have been a blacksmith. Because every time my husband walked in the door, he made a bolt for the door. Dogs are funny animals, you know. Every time he saw another dog, he'd go and sniff their bottom. Imagine doing that every time your dad walked in. And He kept licking his winky. Oh, my husband said, I wish I could do that. I said, give him a sweet, he might let you. Anyway, this one year, we came down and put the Christmas lights on the tree. And we all went up to bed. And when we came down in the morning, the dog had eaten them all. So we rushed the dog to the vet's. And I said, the dog's eaten all the Christmas lights on the tree. And the vet said, don't worry, I'm a dog whisperer. And he bent down and whispered in the dog's ear, you're going to be okay. You're going to be okay. And his little face lit up.
Here we are, welcome to Fitzwarren School.
This is Dame Sarah, our cook.
Pleased to meet you, young man.
I'm Dick.
Oh, that's a very upstanding name, isn't it? But we don't allow pets in the store, I'm afraid.
Oh, but Tommy's no ordinary pet, Dame Sarah. He just chased off all of the rats in town.
Yes, and I've given Dick a job and somewhere to stay. And Tommy, he can chase off the rats for good.
Silly Sally, save the skeleton!
Hiya, kids! It's going to be louder than that!
Never mind, hiya, kids. We've got far too much work to be doing. Now then, this here is Dick. And he's going to be helping us in the store.
Oh, charmed, I'm sure.
Pleased to meet you. This is my cat, Tommy.
Hello, Tommy.
Meow.
Come along, Alice. You can help me pack for the trip. I'll be back later. Love, love.
Okay. Bye, Dick.
Alice.
Okay, Daddy.
Bye, Miss Alice.
Bye.
Now, Dame Sarah, where would you like me to start?
Well, we've got all these deliveries to put away. Now, I've been rushed off my feet since the store opened at 9 a.m. And we've still got lots to do before it closes at 5. Hopping out of bed and a stuff. Hopping out of bed and a pull into the kitchen. Pour myself a cup of ambition. I yawn and stretch and try to come alive. Jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping. Out on the street and the traffic starts jumping. It's folks like me on the job. Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taking and no giving. You could use your mind, but they never give you credit. Things up to drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5 for service and devotion. You would think that I would deserve a fat promotion. Wanna move ahead, but the boss who seems to let me. I swear sometimes that man is out to get me. You're just a step on the boss man's lap, but you've got dreams he'll never take away. You're in the of your friends, waiting for the day your ship will come in, and the tide's gonna turn and it's all gonna roll your way. Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taking and no giving. Use your hands, and the better give you credit. It's enough to drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5 for service and devotion. Wanna think that I would deserve a fat promotion. Wanna move ahead, but the boss who seems to let me. I swear sometimes that man is out to get me. 9 to 5! Woo! Woo! Right, thank you, Jim. Come on, we've got all these deliveries put away. Come on, don't delay. Right then, let's have a look here. Now, the cake goes over here. Get you, shall we? See you later, boys and girls!
Cool, blimey, things are going well. Will Dick prevail? Only time will tell. For he and Tommy have settled it, and now the adventures can begin. But Fitzwarren's found his artful dodger. That's Cockney slang for he's a lodger. But King Rat has something up his sleeve. an evil plan he's trying to weave. He's Minion the Stinker, don't half pen and ink. Well, I'm a loyal stupid dread to think. Oh, but King Rat's wit is far too slender to win against this smart EastEnder. His master plan's no match for me. My secret weapon is Dick and Tommy. Well, I'd love to stay and have a nap, but there's so much to do. I'd better scatter.
Yoo-hoo! Oh, Lavin! Oh, what on earth's going on here? Oh, Sally, wake up! We're on fire! Oh! We're on fire!
Zero, remember my fire safety training?
Ow! Give it to you, duct paper! Honestly! Oh! I knew I shouldn't have trusted you. You've got the brains of a rocking horse.
Oh, I'm sorry, Aaron Sarah, I only fell asleep for a minute.
Well, it's almost the same with you, isn't it? I'm sure you must have that narco electricity.
Oh, I think you mean narcolepsy.
What? That's what I said. Less of your cheek, girl. Right, now go and find me some instant cake mix. That should speed things along. Honestly, boys and girls, I think that girl will be the death of me. Oh, what's this? A piece of cheese? Never mind, hiya kids, we've got far too much work to be doing. Now give me that. Right then, I need you to follow this recipe. What on earth are you doing, you niggerpoop?
I'm doing what you told me and following the recipe.
Oh, we haven't got time for this. We'll have to call in the big guns.
Who are they?
Fetch me the emergency directory. Ah, here it is. Lovely. Right then, let's have a look. Oh no, that's an ex-boyfriend. Oh no, that's husband number 7. Ah, here we go.
Oh. If no one else can help, and if you can find them, maybe you can hire the A-Team.
I'm sorry. The number you have dialed has not been recognised. Please check and try again. Alternatively, press 1 to call the B-Team.
It's the B-Team here! Did you call our line? We're Bartle and Zach! Always on time!
Hiya, Sammy!
Never mind, hiya, Sammy. We haven't got time for flirting. Hang on a moment. Are you trying to pull the wool over my eyes?
Hey?
I'm sure there's meant to be 4 of you in your team. Well, which one's in charge? Ah, yes, you look like you're in charge. You look like you're scared of flying. Right, now which one's the good-looking one and which one's the stupid one? On second thought, you could be the stupid one. Lovely. Right, now then, we just need the face, don't we, to complete this team? Now, where am I going to get the face from?
You face!
Actually, I could get the face from the audience, couldn't I? Oh, yes, I could! Well, I'm going to! And this is when you all look down and go, don't pick me! Right then, I think I need a handsome man. Handsome man. Right then, who wants to come up? Does anyone want to come up for starters? Put your heads down. Well, we do have an age limit for on stage, I'm afraid. No, I'm joking. But I do need a handsome man. Right, let's have a look. Ah, yes, here we go. What's your name, sir? Harry, well, oh, I like your shirt, Harry. Oh, Tommy Hilfiger, lovely. Right, give Harry a round of applause, come on. Come on, Harry, up you come. Come on, turn around, let the audience see you. Here he is, oh, lovely. Right then, Harry, now go and queue up behind the counter. Come on, no, this side, honestly, you should know the script. Lovely, right, you can stay next to me, sunshine. Right, now then, are we ready? That's it, getting all aproned up. Lovely. Right then, now Sally, pass the flower.
Here comes the flower!
Here comes the flower!
Here comes the flower!
And here comes the flower!
Harry, I can see you're going to be a naughty boy, aren't you? Not that sort of flower, Sally! Self-raising flower!
Ew, here comes the self-raising flower!
Here comes the self-raising flower!
Here comes the self-raising flower!
What's a lovely voice you've got? Do you know the script, do you?
You've said it very well. Lovely, now we're getting somewhere. Right then, now Sally, pass me a wooden spoon. Right, now stir in the flour. Not like that, you silly girl. Oh, honestly. Oh, Zach, give me a bowl.
Oh, that's such a volume, dimwit! This sort of bowl!
Well, at least someone's got some brains round here. Right, come on, pass the bowl down. Right, are we ready? Now, put in the flour. Now then, we need to add butter, 1 pound.
Right then, there we go. Butter, 1 pound.
Yes, butter, 1 pound, come on.
Butter, 1 pound.
Butter, 1 pound.
Butter, 1 pound.
Lovely. Now then, sugar, 1/2 pound.
Sugar, 1/2 pound.
Sugar, 1/2 pound.
Sugar,
1/2 pound. Sugar. What's going on back there?
I'm working on it.
What on earth are you doing? Come on, hurry up. Right then, lovely. Now then, milk, 1 cup.
A whole cup?
Yes, that's what I said, wasn't it?
Are you sure that's right?
Yes, I'm reading the recipe word for word. Now put a sock in it.
Put a sock in it?
Yes, sir. Right then, now we've done all that. Now, before we add the eggs, we need to beat the mixture.
Huh? But I don't know how to beat the mixture.
Have you got a hearing problem? I said we need to beat the mixture. Come on, you can take it in turns. Beat the mixture. Well, well, well. Harry, you have been a naughty boy, haven't you? Right there, come on, pass me the eggs from under there. Oh no, that's what he said. Oh no. Right then, now, lovely. Now, we need to crack the egg!
But Dame Sarah, I don't know how to crack an egg.
Oh, you don't know how to crack an egg?
No.
Well, it's quite simple, really. Here, let me show you. Oh! Or do you want a real one? I'll go for the real one. There we go! Lovely! Well, that's great! Right then, now, come on, everyone stop yoking around! Right then, now we've done all that, we need to put it in the oven. And Harry, I think you can go back to your seat. Give Harry a round of applause for getting involved. Right, come on! Where are you? There you are, lovely. Thank you, Harry! Wonderful, wasn't he a great contestant there with us? Right now, we put it in the oven. Lovely. Now we need to turn on turbo power.
Turbo power on.
Lovely. Now the great thing about turbo power is it cooks in a matter of seconds. Oh, there you are, told you so.
Hey, Dame Sarah, this bloke says I'm not his partner.
Well, of course you're not his partner. Get back here. Where's Harry?
Maybe he set the cake in the oven.
Oh, I said put the cake in the oven, not Harry. Get him out, quick! Oh, would you look at that? Oh, what a beautiful cake for Miss Alice's birthday. Oh, job done.
What about Harry?
Oh, yes, Harry. Sorry, Maze, I'm sure there's worse ways he could go. We'll refund this thing and give you a slice of cake in the interval. He must have had a soggy bottom.
Oh, down your tracks, give it a rest. Especially you, you little pest.
Yeah.
So listen up, because I'm the king. If you don't agree, let me tell you one thing. One day you'll all bow to me, because I'm what they call rodent royalty.
Royalty.
Master Dickon better beware, because after tonight no one will care.
Care.
My cunning plan is drawing near to make Dick Whittington disappear. And where he goes, so will his cat.
Cat.
Stinker. Please stop doing that.
Sorry, Master. What's the plan?
Well, do try and follow if you can. We'll make them think that he's a crook, and that dick they'll surely throw the book. They'll cast him out into the street, and my victory will be oh so sweet. But before he's carted off to prison, we'll need a little hypnotism. To get into the safe, I'll get hold of the code from Dame Sarah the cook, then I'll hit the road. Now come on, Stinker, there's no time to spare, for I'm soon to be London's new Lord Mayor.
Now, Tommy, you can't say things don't happen in London. Last night, we didn't know anyone. We had no job and nowhere to stay. But all that's changed in just a few hours. We've made lots of new friends, we've found work, and we have a nice warm place to stay. What's that, Tommy? You're right, Tommy. I do like Miss Alice. You think she likes me too? I hope so, Tommy. Who knows what adventures tomorrow will bring? You never know. This time next week, I can be the new Lord Mayor of London. But a boy can dream. You must be exhausted after all that rat catching. Sleep well, Tommy. You dream of fish and cream, and I'll dream of... I close my eyes and I can see the world that's waiting up for me, that I call my pain. Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say I've lost my mind. I don't care if they call me crazy. We can live in a world that we design. Every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors in my head, a million dreams are keeping me awake. I think of what the world could be, a vision of the one I see. A million dreams is all it's gonna take. A million dreams for the world we're gonna make.
Oh, sorry, dear.
That's okay, Miss Alice. I was only daydreaming.
Oh, I often daydream too.
Well, tell me what you dream about.
Oh, lots of things. One day, I want to see all the wonders of the world.
Me too. This might sound silly, but I often dream of living in a big house filled with magical things from all my travels. And one day, even becoming the new Lord Mayor of London.
Oh, Dick, that sounds wonderful.
Well, all I'd need is someone special to share it all with.
Well, you have Tommy.
Well, that's true. But I meant a girl. Someone I could marry one day.
I see.
Oh, I know this probably sounds crazy, Miss Alice, as we're only just getting to know each other, but I think I'm falling in love with you.
Crazy at all. I feel the same. Fate has brought us together and I want to share everything with you.
There's a house we can build. Every room inside is filled with things from far away. Special things I compile, each one there to make you smile. On a rainy day, they can say it all sounds crazy. They can say we've lost our minds. I don't care if they call us crazy. Run away to a world that we desire. I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head, a
Fixing.
In the bedroom.
Oh, but you don't have a foot poster, Dame Sarah.
Oh, spoil sport! Come on, then, you. Right, it's time you got some beauty sleep. It's your birthday tomorrow. Big day!
Good night, Dick.
Oh, good night, Miss Alice.
Call me Alice.
Good night, Alice.
Oh, come along. I'll get you some milk to take to bed.
Nanny, apart from helping Dame Sarah in the store, I'm also going to trust you with the combinations in the safe. This is a present I bought for Alice's birthday tomorrow. It used to belong to her mother, and I'm keeping it for her 21st birthday. It's very valuable and extremely precious.
It's beautiful. I'm sure she'll love it.
I hope so. I want you to put it in the safe, along with today's takings. Dave said we'll give you the combination. I'm going to bed now, so I'll see you and Tommy tomorrow, and well done, both. You're doing a great job.
Thank you, sir.
Dame Sarah, I'm off to bed. I'm really tired. Good night.
Night, Fitzy. Night. Now then, young man. The combination to the safe is my age and my dress size. So it's 1912.
Okay, that's your age. What's your dress size?
Ooh, you cheeky monkey. Right, are you sure I can trust you with the combination to the safe? It'll only be me and you that know how to unlock it.
Of course, you can rely on me and Tommy.
Oh, wonderful. Right then, I think it's time I did some beauty sleep myself. Not that I need as much as this Alice, you see. It's all in the genes. Right, now time for a nice evening stroll. Ooh, I'm sure this Fitbit's on the brink. It says I need to do another 10,437 steps to reach my target. That'll teach me for using eBay. Right then, see you later, boys and girls!
Bye. What a day, Tommy! We'll sleep tonight!
Stinking sewers, you see me rise. It's nearly time to claim my prize. For night has fallen and the time has come to see the end of Tommy and Whittington.
Master, quick! She's on her way!
Then hide, stinker! Don't delay! I'll lead her on a merry dance and put her in a ratty trance. What's a young treacle like you doing walking about? If I was your old man, I wouldn't let you out.
Ooh, young treacle? Well, haven't been called that in a while.
Oh, well, that says maybe, but it made you smile. Even in this dismal light, you really are a gorgeous sight. Ooh.
Do you know you're talking in constant rhyme?
Of course, my dear, but that's no crime.
Isn't he a catch, boys and girls?
No!
Oh, yes, he is! No!
Oh, yes, I am!
Oh,
I'm 11 out of 10, so shut it!
Well, I've always loved the rough and ready look. Especially one that embraces his masculinity. Oh, the hairier the better, if you ask me.
I've got a little treat for you. A lovely scent by Jimmy Choo.
Oh, I might have known you were leading me on. I've met con men like you before.
Ah, but this one's free. It's sample size. And guaranteed to hypnotise. You should be feeling sleepy now. If you are, move like a cow.
Oh, master, let me have a tinker.
Oh, if you must, but be quick, stinker.
If you're under King Rat's spell, stand on one leg and pick your nose. Oh, it worked, it worked. Can I have another go?
Well, there's no time for this. The answer's no. Now, Dame Sarah, it's time to unload. So give me the safe's combination code.
1912!
Must be the year she was born.
Oh, it worked. I've got what I wanted. And now it's time that I absconded. My scheme will work, I have no doubt. For when she wakes, she'll remember now.
Oh, something's come over me. I feel all funny. Hang on a minute. I'm sure there was a big hairy man stood there before. Wishful thinking, eh, girls? Right then, it's time I get some beauty sleep, I think. See you later!
Stinker, you keep watch while I grab the swag. Then I'll plant it in Whittington's bag.
Oh, what's this I spy? A piece of cheese?
Cheese! Move it, stinker, scram!
Hiya, kids!
Oh, Dick, what's the door doing?
I think the rats must have come back.
Oh, no, 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 no!
What is all the commotion about?
Yes, someone's trying to get some sleep round here. Oh, look, Fitzy! The safe's open, and it's empty!
But it can't be!
Well, see for yourself!
But how? That's what I want to know. Did you give the code to Dick?
Yes, but... Hang on, what are you suggesting?
I'm not suggesting anything. I'm just trying to get to the bottom of things. Did you give the code to anyone else?
Certainly not!
And Dick, did you lock the money and Alice's present in the safe as I asked you?
I did, Mr. Fitzwarren!
Well, I can't think for the life of me what's happened.
Well, I know I'm not the sharpest spoon in the drawer, but I'd hazard a guess that we've been robbed.
Robbed? But who would do such a thing?
Well, a robber.
Let's not jump to conclusions, Sally.
Whatever's the matter, and why is no one in bed?
Well, some things have gone missing from the safe.
Oh, well, I'm sure there's a simple explanation for this. Why don't we start by doing the full search of the shop?
Good idea. Oh, lovely. Right, let's have a look round here then.
No.
Well, blow me down with a feather!
I'd take more than that.
What is it, Dame Sarah?
I found the culprit, Fitzy. It's all here in Dick's bag.
How could you? That's impossible. I didn't take it.
Well, see for yourself.
I haven't done anything. I don't know how they got there.
We trusted you. We invited you into our home. I even gave you a job. You must leave at once and never darken our door again.
Oh, please, Daddy. I'm sure he's innocent.
Don't be fooled by Alice. Don't be fooled by his
rugged looks and gorgeous charm.
Who is G? duped us all!
What a stupid!
Oh, be quiet, you silly girl!
I'm sorry, Alice, but all the evidence points to Dick being a thief!
Oh, you should call the police, Fitzy!
Here we are, fighting, Grub! We're Bottle and Zack! Always on time!
Is that you, Sammy?
Oh, yeah, BC, Sammy's back at your service, Miss Sally.
Blimey, you must be telepathic! You've always loved a man in uniform, haven't you? Must run in the family.
Oh, please, Daddy. Surely we can sort this out ourselves. We don't need to involve the police. I'm begging you.
Please, Mr. Fitzwarren, I promise you I didn't do it.
I'm sorry, Dick, but you're dismissed from my services. You must leave London at once. If you ever try to return, you'll see Miss Alice again. It's prison for you, my boy.
But Daddy, please.
Thank you for believing in me, Alice, but I must do as your father says.
Just take them away, lads.
Don't give me no trouble, lad.
Come on, Tommy.
Take him out.
Oh, Daddy, how could you?
I had no choice, Alice.
Oh, don't worry, Fitzy. She'll see one day you did the right thing. Come on, let's get some sleep. Everything always looks better in the morning.
Oh, dear. Dixon Barney Rabble. For all you Brammies, that means trouble. King Rat has framed him good and proper, and therefore Dick has come a cropper. For they think Dick's an old tea leaf, untrustworthy and reckless. But we know that he didn't steal the money or the necklace. Now, although he can't see me, I'm always near. For the bells of Bow, he soon will hear. Fitzwarren sent him homeward bound, but with help from me, he will be found.
Tommy, I can't believe everyone thinks I'm a thief. If only there was some way I could prove my innocence. But we must leave London for good. I'll never see Alice again.
Have you ever felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear? But you would fall and no one would hear.
At least we have each other, eh, Tommy? Oh, I'm so tired. Let's rest a while by this milestone. And in the morning, we'll carry on back to Gloucester.
Well, let the lonely feeling wash away. Maybe there's a reason to believe you'll be okay. Cause when you don't feel strong enough to stand, you can reach out your hand. And even when the dark comes crashing through, when you need a friend to carry you, and when you're broken on the ground, you will be found.
So let the sun come streaming in, cause you'll reach up and you'll rise again. If you only look around, you will be found. You will be found.
Oh,
my side. The rats were gone. Everyone was cheering and applauding. Now I know what we must do, Tommy. The bells are telling me to return and clear my name. We must go back, Tommy. Back to London town.
Even when the dark comes crashing through, when you need someone to carry you, and when you're broken on the ground, you will be found. So let the sun come streaming in, as you reach up and you rise again. If you only look around, you will be found. You will be. You